Hello guys, welcome to ITS Information Technology Skills. On today's video, we're going to show how to insert or delete a cell, row, or column on your Microsoft Excel in your mobile devices. So let's start. So in this video guys, we're going to use the file that we have created on how to compute the salary using Microsoft Excel on your mobile device. So in inserting a cell in Microsoft Excel, you need to identify what is the cell address. So let's say we want to add a new cell on A2, okay? To do that, just click this symbol to expand the options. Then on Home ribbon, locate Insert and Delete. So under Insert and Delete, we can find here options on how to insert a cell, insert a row, insert a column, and of course, delete a cell, delete a row, and delete column. Okay, so first we're going to use the Insert and Shift Right. Observe that it has a new cell on A2. Then it takes current balance, shift to the right. So that is the use of Insert then Shift to the right. Let's return that to the original location. Just click this and do symbol. Then next, let's try to insert a new cell above A2, okay? So take note, we're going to insert a new cell on this location. So click Insert and Delete under Home ribbon, then click Insert and Shift down. Observe that we have this message, okay? So for some instance, we can receive messages when inserting a cell on your Microsoft Excel. Okay, so just like this, this operation will cause some merge cell to unmerge. Do you wish to continue? Okay, so what is the reason we have this? Just let's click first cancel, because the cell under A2 is being merged. That is cell AB on row 3. Okay, so let's try. Click again, Insert and Delete, then click again, Insert and Shift. Let's try to click Continue. The merge cell become 1. So now let's return it to the original location. Just click this, Undo. So let's try to add a cell for the A3. So take note, A3 for the current file is being merged with B3. Okay, so if we're going to add or insert new cell, let's try shift to the right. We have this message. So this message states that there are one or more circular reference where a formula refers to its own cell either directly or indirectly. This might cause them to calculate incorrectly. So the reason for this message is that the original text under AB row 3 have a formula. Okay, so let's click OK. Then we added 2 cells. So why 2 cells? Because it has a merge cell a while back. And now, observe for the value a while back, it copied its formula. So it just shifted to the right. So the output is just the same, but for some instances, it may cause miscalculation. So let's return this to the original part. Then let's try to insert a cell on cell address B7. Let's try Insert Shift Right. Okay, so click Insert Shift Right. Then observe the output on the computation become 7,000. So it provides us a miscalculation that is not the original computation. So let's return this. It become 6,000 again. Okay, so just take note when you are inserting a cell on your Microsoft Excel or on your file, just make sure that you're going to change the data. Okay, so now guys, let's try to insert row. Okay, so let's say we want to insert a row on row 1. To do that, just click the row number. Okay, so you have here the highlight. Then next, click again the more option to expand. Then under home, same, just locate insert and delete. Then for that, take note we have here insert row and delete row. So why does the other option become unavailable? Because we choose the whole row. Okay, so we can only insert another row or delete a row. So let's try to insert a row. Click this part and observe we added a new row for row 1. Okay, so let's try to undo and return this to its original form. So what if I cannot click the number? What if I click this part, the row 1? So how to insert a row? Again, let's click insert and delete. We also have here insert row. So we can always click this part. Okay, so let's try. Observe. Again, we added a new row, which is the row 1. So what is the difference of insert row and the insert shift down? So for the insert shift down, it will insert only one cell, but for the insert row, of course, it will insert a row. So let's say you want to insert a row on this address. So we have here B8. So basically, we're going to add a row. So 8 now will become empty. So let's return this to its original form. So same with the column. If you want to insert a column, you can click the column header or the letter, then click insert column. Okay, so for the insert column, it will insert a column on the left part. Okay, then you can also insert a column using this. So let's say you want to insert a column on column B. Okay, so I only click one cell under column B, then click insert and delete, then click insert column. Observe, we added a column on column B. So let's return that to its original form. To delete a cell, you need to identify the cell address that you want to delete. So let's say I want to delete the cell on B8. Same, click insert and delete, then delete shift to the left, then delete shift up. So let's try first delete shift left. So if we're going to delete the cell on B8, observe the output. The content or the cell which has a color blue, shift to the left, okay, including the other cells on the Excel or on the row. So now let's return that to its original form. So if we're going to click this, delete and shift up, basically it will going to delete the cell on B8, then the other cells under B8 will shift up. Okay, so let's try. Observe that the data under B8 moves up. Okay, so let's return that to its original form. Same with deleting a row, you can click the row where you want to delete, or you can have the row number. Okay, so we can click the delete row to remove the row that we have selected. Similar with the column, if you want to remove a column, we can always click the column header or the cell under that column that you want to delete. So let's say we're going to delete the balance or column D. So click insert and delete, then delete column. So the data under column D has been deleted. Now let's return that to its original form. So another bonus part for this, you can always format your cell. Okay, so to format your cell, we have here format cell size under insert and delete. So click that part. Okay, so for the format cell, guys, you can change the height of the row. So same for the auto fit and other parts. Okay, so that is our bonus topic. So if you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel using your mobile devices, don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell for more tutorial videos. Bye!